Hey everyone, thank you for watching this new video. So today I'm gonna talk about a book that I read few years ago and I really really loved. So the book is Rent Reruled, written, I don't know if you can see it properly, so this is the book. It was written by Robin Walker. Robin Walker is an historian who teaches adult courses in London. So he was my teacher in London a few years ago. He wrote several articles and books regarding the slave trade, black empowerment, religion, Black Wall Street, and many, many more. He also appeared in the documentary Hidden Color, the religion of black white supremacy, produced by Tariq Nasheed. So the book Rent Reruled was written first in 20. It was published in 2006. A second edition was published in 2013. And this is when I bought the book, and I bought it in 2014, I think. But I read it a few years ago. It took me a few weeks to read it. It's really massive. It's a big book. It's 800 pages. It seemed really, really big and really, really, it must be really impressive, but it's not that difficult to read. The book is about ancient and medieval history of black civilization. It is divided in 22 chapters and it covers topics such as the Egyptian chronology, Carthage and Numidia, the Nok civilization, Great Benin, Ife, the Igbo civilization and the Yoruba civilization, ancient Ghana, Mali and Songhai, the civilization of the Moor, the Central Sahara, Great Zimbabwe, the Indus Valley and Arabia, Ethiopia and the Swahili states, and also the fall of Africa and the resistance. It is very easy to understand and it is very accessible, and it is written in a very simple English with evidences and references the advancement of African culture and technology before the slave trade. And this is the only book that combines so much information about ancient Africa with maps and pictures. Here are a few pictures and drawings that you can find in the book. So this one is a drawing of Congo. I don't know if you can see well. So this drawing is from the 17th century. This is a Sphinx of Giza in Egypt. This is a picture of sculpture of Great Benin. This is a drawing of Queen Zinga, who was a queen warrior of the actual Angola. And here a drawing of a soldier of Kanem-Borno Empire. Here is a picture of Jean-Jacques Dessalines, the first ruler of independent Haiti. And here is a picture of Marcus Garvey. Ancient Africa wasn't a continent populated with the people who used to jump from tree to tree with a bone in their nose. Not at all. On the contrary, Africa was a highly developed continent. The technology was highly developed as well. And in this book, you will learn a lot about the architecture of the buildings. There are a lot of details about the description of the cities and the empires. You will learn also a lot about the economic activities and how the cities and empires were organized. You will discover how people used to live, what clothes they used to wear, what they used to sell, what they used to buy, how they used to live, also what food they used to eat. For example, many kingdoms had internal toilets, and even some had swimming pools. The book comes also with a study guide. So this is the study guide that I highly recommend to buy and to read with the book. The study guide is a 60-day plan guide to help the reader to read the book. So for each day, there is a panel of questions, around 10 and 50 questions for each day. And the questions correspond to a couple of pages of the book. So this book is for everyone interested in gaining more knowledge about African history and ancient African civilization. What I recommend you to do is to read the book with the study guide and to take notes when you follow the questions. Every time you read the book with the study guide, just answer the question by taking a couple of notes. It will be much more easier to read and much more easier to understand. Thank you for watching this video. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel by clicking on the button below. And see you to the next video. Bye.